should you go bottomless? That is what we will be talking about today.
Or rather, I'll let you know the facts and then you can choose to go bottomless or not. Let's be real, it's the pandemic. We've all gone bottomless, maybe once or twice. So why should my portafilter be any exception? Bottomless. Jokes aside, we're gonna talk about two things. Why would you go bottomless or naked? You know what? No, both of them are pretty raunchy. And then we'll discuss my portafilter that I got, which was a third party for my Breville dual boiler machine. I have a review for that on my channel. If you haven't seen that already, you can go check that out. Let's get right into it. Why would you choose a bottomless portafilter? There are many, many advantages to it. So first of all, the Breville dual boiler machine, this came stock with it. This works really great. The espresso was fine that I made with it. And it's especially good if you're two people and you're making two espresso shots. Whenever I'm making drinks, even with people, I'm making one drink, I'm making a flat white. The double spouted doesn't really have an advantage for me in that sense. It took a while before I considered getting myself a bottomless portafilter. It was just extra money I didn't want to spend. And I figured, you know what, let's just play with the machine, get better at it, see if I need it. But you know what? It's just so pretty. That's one of the reasons that you'll want to get it. And I actually made a video called Coffee Porn on my channel that is just, that's one of the reasons. The second reason is when you have a bottomless portafilter, you can actually see if there's any channeling issues. If you're only getting extraction coming out of one side, not the whole thing, you'll see quickly where you made mistakes. And that's great because then you can correct. It's a visual cue to help you. Making espresso is basically like cooking. Cooking, you need to season at every step. For making good espresso, every single step of the espresso process is important to the final result in your cup, in extracting the coffee well and everything. Another advantage with a bottomless portafilter, coffee doesn't need to run through these two spouts. When you stop the extraction, you get maybe 1 or 2 grams more in your cup, whereas with here, I felt it was somewhere close to 4 grams, which makes getting the right output a little bit difficult getting exact. So let's say I was looking at the scale, cool, I'm at 36 grams, then I stop it, goes all the way to like 40 grams, and that's not exactly the yield I wanted, and that changes pretty drastically the taste of the cup. Whereas here, with the bottomless, when you cut the coffee and you cut the water and you cut the pressure, it just stops and very little comes out. And let's talk about Crema. As you can see on a bottomless portafilter, you get more Crema, about 50% more yield according to some websites. And you'll also notice that there are larger bubbles in said Crema because it doesn't come into contact with anything other than the basket. The coffee goes directly into your cup. Whereas on a double spouted portafilter, it will come in contact with more metal. It'll cool down a little bit as well because of that thermal mass. And you may have a metallic taste. The possible dirty spouts could contaminate and affect the taste of your cup. But because it's going through the spouts, you'll also get finer texture Crema. So when it comes to taste between the two, I don't think I can taste the difference. I'm better at espresso, but not to that point of tasting those small nuances. However, Sprometheus, who's a really big coffee YouTuber, you've probably seen his videos by now. He has a video, which I'll link below, that talks about the taste between the two. The last thing I remember watching from him is that he liked the taste better in the double spouted portafilter. I cannot tell the difference. Another advantage is you also get more height clearance. See between the two, you get more height clearance if that's an issue for you with your cups. With me, they both work, except for this one, I had to kind of wiggle my cup in to take into account the double spouts, whereas this one, I can just stick it underneath. Another advantage I realized that a bottomless portafilter had that I only realized when I was doing my cleaning. I haven't seen other people comment on, so this is a bonus advantage that you're getting exclusively here. You would use less Cafiza cleaning powder, what you would use to back flush your machine, but also to clean out all that gunky coffee oils that basically become glue and residue on all of your different parts of your machine, including your portafilter. And because it doesn't have the spouts and everything that you have to go into, you actually don't have to use as much powder. You don't have to use as much liquid. Of course, keep everything proportional as they suggest, so you can be a little bit less wasteful because it's just a basket. I will also link Cafiza powder in the description below. Whereas here, you have the double spout. There's the base right here because it's not a naked bottomless portafilter. You have the double spout is touching the coffee. So now I'm gonna talk to you about this portafilter that I got. This is actually the second one I got off Aliexpress. I will link it down below. Aliexpress is a website that is based in China that you can basically purchase directly from manufacturers, or I think there's also like, it basically think of it as Amazon. But in China, it's massive. If you haven't heard of it already, massive. If you're going for third party, make sure to check reviews if there are any. If not, you're taking a chance. I think this one didn't have any reviews. I ended up taking a chance on it. It came with its own basket, which looks to be, a basket that's in between a single and a double. I even identified it just to make sure I don't mix it with my Breville ones. It looks like it's fine. I mean, I didn't take it under a microscope, but it looks fine. I just don't use it because I'm used to using the double. I like it. This has a slight angle. I just don't want to start messing around and learning everything on a new basket. I'm good with the double basket from Breville. I just popped it and then stick it in this one, and it works fine. The reason that I got this instead of the Breville one, first of all, I like the look of the wood handle. I just found that so much more elegant. It doesn't quite match the Breville dual boiler because the rest of it is just this brushed stainless steel, but I love the look of this. Whereas the official Breville naked bottomless portafilter is a plastic black one that looks like this but is naked, and I just think that's very boring, so I'm not a huge fan of that. The second thing, it's also much cheaper. I believe this is like often out of stock because everything related to coffee now is out of stock because, you know, still COVID. Everybody wants to buy coffee, make coffee at home. Everyone wants to become a home in quarantine, and then like all of the supplies and shipping and this is cheaper. This came to about $42.25 US, $55.50 Canadian, whereas the Breville naked bottomless portafilter, $80 USD, $120 Canadian. So that's a significant price difference. It's more than half, plus tax. This had no tax. The only disadvantage is you have to wait. It took about 2 to 3 weeks for it to arrive for me in Canada. That's fine. I mean, I could still make coffee with this. It's just a matter of testing my patience and not refreshing the tracking page all the time. But it's here now. This is the second portafilter I got, and the other one worked perfectly fine and it looked great. The reason that I got this one instead was minor. First of all, it has like these nice, like the metal piece in the back, whereas the other one was just one long wood handle. But the main difference is it didn't have this lip. So that's my tip, because when you want to do the clear water back flushing before you shut off your machine and you just want to rinse out three-way solenoid valve, if you want to use the technique from Phil from Sage/Breville, yeah, the wiggle technique, then you need to have this lip, because the other one didn't have a lip, ended up leaking all over my hand and just burning my hand. That wasn't particularly fun, so I decided to sell it, and then I got this one with the lip. But the funny thing is, I don't even do that technique anymore. Whatever. The other thing that I noticed with this bottomless naked portafilter, I can compare the double-spouted Breville portafilter. I noticed that the little lip here is a little bit less deep than the original. It doesn't seem to cause any issues in terms of actually connecting. The only thing is that I need to twist this in further, and then it's kind of off angle like that, which, do I care that much? I mean, I care a little bit, but I don't care that much. So all in all, I'm quite happy with this portafilter. The only negative is that this lip thing, which works, gets a nice seal. You need to rotate it more. That's the only thing. That's everything when it comes to a bottomless naked portafilter. Let me know in the comments below if you're gonna get yourself one. I feel like I'm in a game show. Let me know if you're gonna get yourself a bottomless naked portafilter. It's just really funny to say naked bottomless portafilter. Nope, just me. Maybe. I've had a few coffees today. And then, you know, do the usual, like, comment, share, subscribe, and see you in the next video. Peace. Bye.